Greetings and welcome. We are now back in our Monday a.m. June 10th session, and we're about to do a writing session that begins with jam writing and then on to our typing project. Now, when you do jam writing, any color ink or pencil is allowed, and some students actually like to write differently. So, Mr. Winlock, can I just see your paper for a sec? Some students will jam write. Are you ready for this? They'll jam write this way. One of the reasons they do that is to remind themselves that it's jam writing and they can write anything they want, any way they want, because they feel like this is too much predictable. Do you know what I'm saying? However you want to do it is fine. However you want to do it is fine. Our top, yeah, I've had students that jam write with crayon or whatever. Doesn't matter to me as long as the pen doesn't stop. Jam writing topic. As soon as you hear it, you're logged in, today's date, write the topic all the way across the top of the page every time you hear it. It's usually a pretty short topic. Put your computer so it's out of the way. It's not a distraction for you. All handheld devices are off of your tabletop unless you're going to be using stuff for music. That's all, right? In other words, I don't want any texting coming up or anything to distract you is all during this 10 minutes. And your topic is this. Who do you admire? And why? Who do you admire and why? Ready? Go. Move the pen. can write about someone who you don't admire. That would also be fine if you run out of things to write about. Okay, we're going to kind of cut short our jam writing just a little bit today because our topic for our writing is exactly the same topic as the jam writing. I recommend real quickly that you go with another color ink, in this case maybe red if you wrote in blue or black ink, to your jam writing real quickly and see if you can come up with three reasons why you admire the person you are writing about. And literally underline it and put a little number out in the margin. 1, 2, 3. Can you come up with three reasons why you wrote about or you gestured towards respecting or admiring this person? That will make it very easy for you in a second to log on to your computer. Now, you should have already logged on. You should have already had a file saved. Remember, when you come back from your break, well, good number, you were moving books for me. Obviously, you didn't have the chance. I apologize for that. But normally, you want to just set up your file, have your date there, your name on it, so when you're ready to print here in a second, you're good to go. The topic on this one makes sense. Lives of great men all remind us we can make our lives sublime. I'm really asking you, to this point in your life, what footprints have you looked at by somebody in front of you who you respect or you admire? The question is a simple one. Who do you admire? And three reasons why. Now, we're shooting for four paragraphs on this one. First paragraph, introduce and name the person. Next three paragraphs, one reason for each paragraph of why it is you admire or respect this person. Now, we are looking for at least a minimum of three paragraphs. So for those of you who show up to Ms. Laird's desk this afternoon and you do not have all of your typing done, Ms. Laird may ask you to go ahead and continue to work and finish the writing. So you want to stay very focused to try and get at least three paragraphs, preferably four. All right? An intro paragraph followed by three paragraphs. All right? Questions? We all understand what we're saying. Mr. Drollinger looks at Mr. Lawler. Thank you. Good question. What if I have two people? Choose one of the two, but you don't have to say it's the most important person that you admire. It's just one of the people you admire. So you're only writing about one person. All right? Mr. McAfee, question?
There's no home directory.
Ms. Laird maybe will need to take a look. Mr. McAfee telling us that he's the H drive for him. Is anybody else not being able to access H drive? Make sure you've saved. Right now, do it. Make sure you saved your file to your H drive. Is anybody else having trouble doing that? It's okay. Yeah, always get a title. Sorry, Mr. Bolts, go. Easy. Very easy. Just what you jam wrote on. Who do you admire and three reasons why? Okay? Who do you admire and three reasons why?
Just three paragraphs on why I admire.
You got it. The three paragraphs. The first paragraph will just be kind of your intro. Does that make sense, Mr. Bolts? And again, make sure you're saving what you're doing.
This printer to my computer here. Is that a very difficult thing to do?
To that one?
This one here.
Yeah, I can. Do you still have that little sticky note I gave you that had the IP address on it? No matter. I can look it up on the computer.
I think I put that in the middle.